sworn to be the boss.
Oh, sworn.
Captain, destroyed.
Come on, man.
Destroyed.
But my point is that it doesn't matter.
It does matter. The truth matters.
Now it matters.
Now the truth always matters. The reason why blacks and Hispanics are in the condition that they're in is because you believe in lies and emotions. If you slow down to realize how this country really runs, and that it's ran by thieves, and you're giving stupid TV shows. Let me finish.
I don't discount that at all. I agree with you 100%.
Let me finish my point.
Go ahead.
If you're giving stupid TV shows on a third grade level, if you're giving sports, you're fed sports constantly, and if you're following religion constantly instead of going in the Bible and finding out the truth, like this is wrong.
The Bible's different than the TV shows?
Like this. No, I said you're giving TV shows.
No, you're saying instead of the TV show,
the idols, and the people that like, most young black and Hispanics look up to, Puerto Ricans, are these idols. Whereas the Bible speaks against this. So if you constantly feeding this to children over and over again, what are you going to produce? Like a factory.
Absolutely.
Like a factory.
I agree 100%.
Close that F1 6 again.
Yeah, I agree that.
Like a factory. I know you don't want to hear it because you're locked into the system.
Oh, no, I'm not locking that system.
A factory is bad. I'm telling you, a factory is bad. It will produce
are you telling me
bad product.
Me being locked into the system.
America is a factory that has produced bad product.
When I say that I love you and care about all these people,
that's
that
good.
I'm locked into the system?
No.
That I have a fucking problem?
No, the fact that...
What do you think?
Let us answer you. The fact that you said that the problem is everybody's problem when everybody doesn't run the system, when blacks and Hispanics are mainly oppressed by the system, shows that you're locked into the system. How is this everybody's problems when the blacks are being oppressed in Harlem, oppressed in Brownsville, oppressed in Bedford-Stuyvesant, oppressed in Coney Island
So you're saying I agree with you 100%.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
So let me finish my point.
Having those problems, that the people that are oppressing them, they don't have a problem.
I don't care about their problem.
Their problem is that they're fucking oppressing those people.
No,
they have a fucking problem.
But all people, he's a madman, right? Look how he's looking at you. He's like, you're a madman. I'll read that real quick. You're a madman.
I love all you people. I'm a madman.
Check it out, yo.
I'm not preaching anything.
What's it? 4 verse 6.
Let's take care of each other. That's it.
Check it out.
Period.
Check it out. Let's move on. Now we're going to the Bible.
I don't need a Bible to tell me to take care of
my people are destroyed.
The Lord said his people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
You gotta come back, man.
That's so good. You gotta come back, man. Stop on last. You are brothers.
That's
you
right.
Puerto Ricans, you gotta wake up.
It doesn't matter what I am.
It does matter who you are.
I care.
A Puerto Rican, look up here, but man.
Please.
A so-called Puerto Rican will not, I trust them more than the so-called white man. A so-called Dominican, as ignorant as you are, without the Bible, I trust them more than the so-called white man.
White people's parents.
Because the white man is killing you every day, and he's killing the so-called black man every day. When you look at Rikers Island, it's filled with blacks and Hispanics. You understand? Yet we're divided through gangs and religion. You are our brothers. You understand? Ephesians 4:13, drop that real quick. One more before you go. Because who you call Christ, we say Yahweh Shah in Hebrew, that's the power. Who you call Jesus Christ, that's the power. It does matter.
I know.
No, you don't.
I know.
Look up here.
To be nice, to be friendly, to love.
Marla.
I know.
Marla.
I don't need Christ to tell me nothing.
Marla, look.
I know.
Marla, look up here.
To be good.
Listen,
to each other.
Read that.
It's easy.
Look up here.
Don't steal. Don't rape. Don't kill.
In the unity of the faith.
Read it again for them.
Till we all come in the unity of the faith.
Till we all come in the unity of the faith. To hell with the white man and the white woman.
He's saying.
Huh?
That's what he's saying.
No, he's not. He's saying the whole world gonna come together. That's not gonna happen. When in the history of this planet has the whole world come together in unity?
Well, but I think it's a consciousness thing that we're working toward.
My people have been in this country for 400 years, and it's been stolen for over 400 years.
Where are they from?
When in the history of this country have we all come together?
Oh, no, I'm not saying that they
have. You said we're working to
that's what I'm saying.
So how close have we come?
I'm just saying that maybe it's just a work in progress.
Are you kidding me? That's a long work in progress, then.
But
it's not going to happen. I just told him.
You're just arguing on a time base.
I just told him that a lot of whites should fear the phenomenal rate of how Puerto Ricans and Dominicans and Hispanics are having children. That's a threat to you people. Because if they continue to have children as they're having them, you'll be voted out of positions in various states. You'll be outnumbered. It's not rocket science. So you have to give us AIDS. You have to kill us through diseases. You have to send us off to war. You have to just have us kill each other in order for you to be protected. You said yourself, people want to survive for themselves and their children.
That's right. And they make up all this
shit
to try to protect each other, and it's wrong.
Sir,
all you have to do is know.
Sir,
your parents teach you
No what? No what? They don't know nothing.
Oh, okay, listen, perfect. Listen, where are you from?
I'm going to bring this up for a second, right?
Okay. So
we know about Rome, right?
God,
we
know
about
Rome, right? I know that book.
Okay, you don't know how to listen.
You don't believe in books? That's not the Bible.
I don't know.
You don't believe in books? You don't believe in books?
I'm going to show you something that nothing changed, right? This book called The Beginning of Babylon.
Please.
Okay, The Beginning of Babylon, right? Now, this is how the Romans feel about black people. You know, the Jews that was in Rome that were black people. This is how the Romans feel about black people. It said, in the 2nd century AD, the celebrated medical scholar Galen, the present doctor, Emperor Marcus Aurelius, right? The Roman emperor, right? Gave the description of the Negro race in Rome, right? It says, according to Galen, the Negro is characterized by his creepy hair, metal growth of beard, long nostril, thick lip, right? Evil body, smell, right? And black complexion. That's what the Romans said about black folks, right? Right, he's like a clay finger, clay foot, has long penis, and is personally found of all kinds of things. They said, in the main observation, they are true. They're only a very noble display in the way Galen put black people as the most despicable people God have chosen. That's what they said. This was ancient Rome. So we in America today, 2017, ain't nothing changed.
No,
so that guy,
they need to teach the Puerto Rican that he's black. That's what they need to teach him. Because they're going around talking about they're white.
You need to tell him that. Well, he's getting it. Steve, right? His name's Steve. He's getting it.
You tell him.
I'm telling him. We've been telling him for over an hour. You understand? You understand? But you see how that guy was balling. You saw how he thinks, right? You see how he thinks. A lot of Puerto Ricans and Dominicans, you think that way. You see what's happening in Virginia? Those race riots are coming. And check it out. The so-called black man, he's so delusional, he's not ready for that. He's not ready for this.
There's many black races, and they're all just denying their African heritage. That's an affront to...
But you're Jews.
And I'm light-skinned.
No, you're Jews.
Huh?
You're Jews. We're out here telling you you're Jews.
I'm black.
You're God's chosen.
What color is this? I'm African.
What color is that?
That's black, but I'm African.
Not African.
Black. Yes, I am.
Your people fled into... You're Jews.
I'm African descent.
Not African. You're a Jew. What
I'm not no Jew. I'm not no Jew.
You're going to find out.
What are you?
I'm a Jew.
Oh, okay.
That's what I'm telling you.
Okay, you say you're light skinned, right?
Right.
You know, when
I know where I got this light skin from.
Right. Not all the time, miss. Not all the time, because you can remember when God created the children of Israel, he created them in different shades of brown. Because your light skin doesn't mean because your light skin doesn't mean your ancestors were raped by the slave master. It does not mean all that. Not all the time.
You got a glass of milk.
Right.
When you got that chocolate in there.
No, not all the time. Not all the time, sis. Not all the time. You know why? Give me Genesis 2:7 for a second. What the brother's showing, the African doesn't acknowledge you, miss. If you go to Harlem right now,
okay,
the African don't want nothing to do with you. You know that?
I acknowledge
that. You know what an African woman told me one time?
But if you have education,
you should know that you're not Africans. We did not came of the race of Ham. You know about Ham race, right? We came of the seed of Shem. We are Jews. We Israelites. We did not came of the seed of Ham. We Israelites. Even when I read a movie called Our Roots, when the brother said,
so you seem
like Moses.
African-American.
So-called African-American. You can't be two nationalities. African is a white man.
We're saying just like Jesus and Moses, they had people that came after them. They fled into Africa.
Right.
And then Africans sold those Jews, black Jews, to the Europeans. So today you think you're Africans because you came from Africa on the slave ships.
Right.
We're trying to tell you that you are a Jew. Like he said just a little while ago, you got Africans, they don't bond with you. They don't link up with you. They just want to get with you when they want to sell you something.
Right. Even if you have access.
Hold on.
So we got to ask you a question just now. You know about Adolf Hitler, right?
Oh, yeah.
Adolf Hitler had a book called Mein Kampf. It's a German my story. Mein Kampf means my story in German, right? It shows you that Hitler said that the only Jews he known of all his life are black people. Why Hitler said that? Then Kennedy said the same thing. Kennedy said, what are we going to tell God we persecute black people as his chosen people? Kennedy said that in 1962. Then another guy came back and said the same thing, right? He's a guy by name Jimmy Carter. Jimmy Carter have a book called The End of Apartheid. Jimmy Carter said that these people that's in Israel today, they are not Jews. They don't belong there. They are Gentiles. And Bill Clinton didn't like what Jimmy Carter said. And we got other people said the same thing. But
I gotta go.
This is a book.
Sorry.
Thank you for the letter.
Right, listen, I want you here.
Right.
This is a book for called From Babylon to Timbuktu by Rudolf Winston. Do you know what he said when he found out through his research?
No, and I think I'm getting
the relation. He says, in the year 65 BC, the Roman armies under General Pompey captured Jerusalem. In 70 AD, General Vespasian and his son Titus put an end to the Jewish state.
So, miss.
Put an end
to the Jewish state, right? So, when you look up, when you look up the history of Rome, right? The first time the white man converted to Judaism was during the time of what? During the time of the Romans. When you read Revelation 2 and 9, John said, I know thy work and tribulation, and I know the blasphemy of them who say they are Jews that are not, but are sinning God's sake, right? Now, he got to show you that the Jews that they're slaughtered in Rome in 70 AD, those are black people. Keep reading.
General Vespasian.
Well, that was the beginning of birth.
Listen. I want you to hear this. It's very important. It says, General Vespasian and his son, Titus, put an end to the Jewish state with great slaughter.
With great slaughter. I mean, great death, right? Go ahead.
During the period of the military governors of Palestine, many outrageous and atrocities were committed against the residue of the people.
Right, man.
During the period from Pompey to Julius, it has been estimated that over 1 million Jews, fled into Africa.
No, if they were, the Jews were white, why would they flee into Africa? What color are the Africans? Black, right? Yeah. So they fled into Africa, which is Egypt.
But white men, they're always going into Africa.
But no, miss. What I'm saying to you, we're showing you Jews are black. Listen. Go ahead.
Over one million Jews fled to Africa, fleeing from Roman
persecution.
Persecution and slavery.
And slavery, go ahead.
The slave markets were full of black Jewish slaves.
Black Jewish slaves. It didn't say white Jewish slaves because there's no such thing as white Jews. No such thing. Okay?
So there's no such thing as a white Jew.
There's no such thing as a white Jew. These people that come, give me Isaiah 34 and 5. Okay? These people that come say Jews today are not Jews. Isaiah 36 and 5.
I'm sorry, I ain't calling
these people are not Jews, huh?
I ain't calling myself
Jews. No. Sis, we're showing you what kind of the Jews are.
Well, let me ask you, do you believe in Jesus?
Jesus was not white, I'm sorry, black.
Okay, so now if the Jews of Jesus is black, Jesus was a Jew and he had a people, right? Wouldn't they be black too?
Of course.
So where are they? Are you saying that these are Jesus people? Or would Jesus people look like me and you?
Like us.
Okay. So you heard the story of the Jews in Egypt serving slavery, right? Those weren't white people being enslaved by black people, right? So we have to put on our thinking caps. The Jews have to be people. We know they're black because Jesus is black. We don't worship a white Jesus. So where are they today? You have a choice. You can be African, or you can be a Jew, a black Jew. And we just read that history book. We have other books that show that the Jews were people of color. You understand? Look at this. Ancient pictures of black Jews. You understand? This is during that Assyrian captivity. So that shows what? That the Jews are black. So we have to look into that thing. You understand? Now, the brother made a point. He said, you got Africans all up and down in Harlem. Down on Fulton and O Street. Down by Gates Avenue and O Street. They don't bond with you. We have a spirit. You have a lively spirit. You saw when you were saying, I'm African, you was all lively. You don't see Africans, women acting like that. You don't see black young men acting like Africans. Africans have a dead spirit. We have a lively spirit. Who are the great boxers? You have a few Africans, but many black people. Who are the great football players? You got white people, a couple of Africans, but many so-called black people who are the salt of the earth. Those are the real Jews.
Right. Okay.
Well, can you see the 36? Nice
okay.
Take care now.
36.
Power to the people.
Okay. So when we're showing the people out here today, that we're showing you that. According to the Bible, these people are not. These people are not Jews. What you guys talk about?
Yeah, there's a question.
I remember you from the tribe of Simeon. Get out of that white man thing.
Yeah. All right, get it together, bro.
You're not white. You're brown skin like us. Okay.
Like us.
All right. Okay. So now, excuse me, sir. Where you from? You from Israel?
From Israel.
Oh man. All right. No.
I have a question for you.
Yeah.
What is Nedev? The difference is
Well, you know what? You know,
ask you a question, right? What the first you learn in school? You cannot answer a question with a question. You have to first answer my question, right?
School told me.
No, I'm just asking you. I'm just trying to show you.
Okay.
You understand? Answer my question, right? I ask you what tribe you're from.
And we don't know.
You don't know. But you're Jewish.
I don't care.
You don't care.
No.
Yeah, but listen, if I was a Muslim, I'ma defend Muslim to the teeth. You saw me defend Judaism. I ask you what tribe you're from. If you're a Jew, what tribe are you from?
We don't know.
You don't know.
I don't see myself.
How you can know from which tribe?
You could know what tribe you're from according to the characteristic of the tribe. Okay? The brother writing from the tribe of Judah, the sister writing from the tribe of Ephraim. That's a real Taino Indian sister right you're looking at. The real native of Puerto Rico. Okay? That's a Jew right there. Sister's a Jew, and that's a Jew right there. And the brother right there, you could tell they're Jewites. I'm a Benjamite. And we can prove to you that our characteristic of the tribe right now. The white men that come said, Jews today, give me Ezekiel 36:5. Those are not Jews. Your ancestors came from ancient what? From Canaan.